Hello again, everybody, and welcome back to LPFWA, the show where there's wrestling and matches. Yeah. I was an energy drink, by the way, because I had to work today, so I am tired, and I need energy, so I'm gonna drink it. That's what an energy drink does. That's how this works. Perfect. But yeah, last week sure was a show. We crowned our LPFWA Women's Champion for the first time. Somehow, things didn't go quite as planned. It was interesting. But I'm sure everything's fine today. Nothing unusual will happen whatsoever. It's impossible. And yes, hello everybody. Welcome. Oh yeah, the first match. This is a big one. Bone Pimp, the Buskus Champ versus Fruit Sniffer, the first ever Buskus Champ. Yeah. Oh man, and Garbo Girl is going against Konami. Garbo must be really upset that she didn't get the Pokemon's title last week. Because, you know, things happen. Unforeseen things. Man, Kylo sure looks edgy in his new getup. I like it. Yes. Unlikely Roommates versus Third Street Sinners. The unlikely tag team champions. And hey, oh. Looks like Helena is making her way to the ring. Oh, right, the LPFWA Women's Champion, Helena. Did it just say Helena? Nadira, of course. I mean, she beat Lady of the Lancet and Helena in a ladder match, so. Silly mistake. Of course, she's gonna cut a promo on, you know, winning the belt. She's the first ever women's champion, so hey, she gets to talk a bit. Huh? Oh, now it's Helena and she. Wait. They both have the title? Well, that makes sense. I agree with this. Ah, yes, translating. Oh yeah, me to the rescue. I'm the only one who can solve the situation. Look at this, I'm so good. Well, it's settled then. At the next pay-per-view, whatever that'll be, the main event will be a match to unify the timelines. I think. I'm not sure that's just said, but I think that's it, yeah. But, you know, let's move on to the actual meat of the show. The violence! Which is fake because it's wrestling. Actually, it's real, it's just. I don't know, you know what I mean. Oh yeah, Bone Pimp. The third man of the Third Street Sinners. And he's not allowed to compete together with them, or even accompany them to ringside for as long as he holds the Buskus. Because the Buskus is kind of... yeah, he's not allowed to do anything. Because that's the rules that I made up at some point in time. I'm not sure why I did it exactly that way, but I did it that way. Yeah, here comes Fruity, the man who lost his hug. He still has his hug life tattoo on his stomach, though. Well, hell, you say the least wanted belt, but it's actually the most prestigious belt in the universe. I could prove that with math if you wanted to, but, you know, I'm just not gonna do it. To, like, just keep the magic alive, you know? Purple versus hot pink, I like it. Those are two nice colors, actually. I like them. They're good. Of course, Boom Pimp would start strong. The Buskus Champ usually gets offense in before he gets his ass kicked completely in a squash match. Actually, leave behind the scenes info. It is impossible for it to be a squash match if the one who would be squashed gets like a move in that knocks the opponent down. Oops, I ruined it. Yeah, purple is better. I like purple better too. It's a good color. I have a purple shirt even. Also has pink on it. Oh, look at them. Look at him just disrespecting Fruity. He knows he's insecure about his like lack of hugging abilities. Like he has hugging abilities, he just, I don't know. Like, you know, Fruity's the best hugger in the business, and yet he's so insecure about it. Because somebody hugged him once instead of him hugging them. It's a complicated story, really. Actually, it isn't. I just told you all of it. I'm not sure if we'd be upset if this ended by countout. Oh man, Fruity going for the pin over the outside. I don't think he understands the rules. We're on 7, right? I think so. I hope that one day Fruity can regain his hug. I mean, that technically counted as a hug. Aww. That was decidedly not a hug. I thought Fruity was going for Bronco Buster there, somehow. Good enough though, I can dig it. Aw man. One count, holy shit. the great Fruit Sniffer, who actually destroyed three of New Japan's best in a single match. Just got a one count there. Or, like, kicked out at one, I mean. Wars are difficult sometimes, you know. Funnily enough, they come easier to me when I'm drunk. Which isn't me now. And Fruity could go for the hug anytime now. He did a six just now. But he doesn't feel it. He wants to go for a pin. Oh man, he should have known that's not enough. Oh, he's thinking about it really hard. Oh, he's hugging! He's doing it! Will it work though? He hugged Bone Pimp! This could be the comeback of Fruity. And Taraxxus, I'm not actually drinking anything. I have no booze in the house. I know, tragic oversight on my part, I didn't get to buy any. So I have to stay sober. Or get to stay sober. Maybe I can just experience LPFWA in new and exciting ways while not being in a clouded state of mind. Perhaps that is what's gonna happen. It's okay, Taraxxus. Sometimes you just gotta not drink. That's life.
What's up?
Oh, hey, I got a friend here.
Yes. It is me, F Master.
Yes, Fruity just actually hugged somebody, by the way.
Did he now?
Oh yeah, he did.
I missed it.
Well, maybe he will hug again now. Maybe this wasn't just a fluke.
Yes.
Maybe he's back. We'll see.
Maybe.
He has another match tonight. It's not canon, technically, but we'll see what happens there.
Nice. I take it we don't have a new Buskus champ, then.
Nope. In fact, Bone Pimp has officially held the title for longer than Lotus.
Damn. Well, as they say, boning ain't easy.
True, true. And here comes Konami. She's really good. In a different timeline, perhaps, she could have been in the finals of the LBFWA Women's Championship match. Tournament.
Yeah.
Words. Difficult.
Could be. But she did still lose in that timeline anyway, so...
Yeah, I don't know. Like, which timeline are we on? I don't even know. It doesn't matter. Okay, I think Garbo Girl finally needs a win.
Yes.
Like, she's lost her debut, and like last week she tried to like attack Rara backstage, but something unforeseen happened, and you know.
I mean, she did help Crate get, I don't know, a million pinfalls.
I don't know. Well, oh, she comes with Garbo Barba.
It's like way behind.
Yeah, I mean, she's just
kind of funny.
She's just picking up after her, I guess.
What is happening with Garbo's walking animation?
Which Garbo?
the trash collector.
Okay, the short answer is I don't know. The long answer is I have absolutely no idea.
Well, short answer is this game is garbage.
Oh, well, Automat actually filtered out a message because it contained the word trash. Here, I'll allow it. here we go.
Oh. And I'm off to a strong start.
Yep. Just, yeah.
Is the bot broken?
Nope.
Oh, it didn't mention anything about bets.
Like, it should work. Oh, fuck, I forgot the bets. Well, we'll do that for the next match, then. I knew I forgot something. This seemed a little bit too easy. You know, I'm better at this when I'm actually drinking, which I'm not right now. Well, but Fruity, white trash is not an offensive term, it's the truth. Well, Konami's just disrespecting here.
Oh, that works.
Welp, I knew I would mess something up, and I deserve this chant.
Well, you haven't broken the timeline yet, so could be worse.
I mean, you mean it didn't break it more?
No.
I mean, I'm glad Gar will get some moves in. After Konami almost just straight up schooled her.
She got moves, and then she proceeded to punch and kick the air, so...
It's kind of her thing. Oh, she's going for her finish already. The demon banishing uppercut. Oh yeah, she's doing it. Show her you can.
Ooh.
And one, two, three, yeah.
And she won.
I went fast. I think maybe Garbo needs a redemption arc.
Maybe.
I mean, so far she didn't really make a very strong impression. I don't know. Might be bad luck.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, she lost in her debut to DCB, so what does that tell you?
I mean, DCB has a Kawhi title match tonight.
Yeah.
She's clearly, no longer... She's actually the lowest ranked still, yeah. I doubt she will ever claw herself out of that pit ever, like, because, I don't know. We'll take, like, a ton of wins.
Yeah.
Now she wins more often, but usually by countout.
Yes. Apparently, she's just fine with that now. Can't beat them, kick their ass on the outside of the ring, and then run back in.
Oh yeah. Well, she's not doing it intentionally, I don't think. Right, here we have a match, and actually bets.
Oh.
I'm not forgetting them now. I mean, I already forgot them. I know this is a personal problem, but I always kind of feel like singing along to this. I shouldn't.
Is this Annalita's reward for winning at the pay-per-view? A match of Macromen?
He gets a match! Yeah, he gets a match. That's his reward. Exactly. like, what? Oh, yeah, right. The last time we did this eight-man thing, the, well, we didn't have a winner. It was a tie, and as a reward, I got a match. I remember now.
Well, at Tox Party, Annalie won the Battle Royal.
Yeah, yeah, that was the second, like, eight-man match we had.
Ah.
Like, the first one went a little bit differently. Oh, yeah, here comes Macro Man.
Teaching us about the economy.
Yeah.
And carrying on the legacy of Macho Man now that he's departed.
The legacy of Macho Man, which is apparently capitalism. Are heavily in favor of Macro here. No one believes in Anil.
Well, they believe in the economy.
Yeah. Alright, here we go.
Oh. And here we go. Macroman's already kicking ass.
I mean, I wouldn't call that ass kicking yet.
Well, he started off the match.
Like, what Konami did last match, that was ass-kicking.
Mmm.
Okay, now it's ass-kicking.
Yes. The ass has been kicked. Or dropped from the mat. Close enough.
Same thing.
Ooh. Neil reversed. Somehow.
Yep, and now he's kicking ass. Quite literally, actually.
Yeah. Kick him back. Go a little lower next time. Well, the Macro Man's back on the offense.
You know, the best part about Anil's matches is that it's usually a huge back and forth.
Yeah. Oh, well, I would certainly hope so, Toraxis.
Yeah, this is
not
PG.
Not that kind of wrestling league.
This is
PG. It's not that kind of...
It's not even PG, I'm lying.
But it's not that kind of wrestling league.
Yes, it's not that kind of wrestling league. I think. I'm not sure anymore. I hope so. Yeah, climb that corner turnbuckle and then climb down again. That's how this works. Proud of ya.
Well, he was prepping for a top rope nothing, and then he hit it.
Oh yeah, airplane spin, the legendary move.
Whoa. Got the count. Damn.
Is he doing a deadlift? No, he wouldn't do that.
No.
Deadlifting wasn't invented yet when Macho Man was a wrestler.
Hmm.
I think. I don't know.
Well, I mean, it was a thing, it just...
Yeah. Yep, that looked like it hurt. If I knew the name of the move, I would say it, but I forgot.
Oh, he's setting up for something.
Oh no, not that move. That one's vicious. I mean, yeah, that move, that rules.
The Alberto Del Rio move.
Yeah, Anil is as cool as Alberto Del Rio, and way easier to work with.
I was gonna say, if he really pulled an Alberto Del Rio, he would have no-showed this match.
Yeah, I mean, Anil only blows people up, you know?
Yeah.
Elbows to the face. classy.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh. A wonky looking dropkick.
That's some kind of kick, yeah. The animation's really weird, it comes out really fast.
Yeah. Also, it doesn't like it when you do it in the corner or next to the ropes.
Oh, pile driver!
Ooh.
This move is instant death. Like, supposed to be, but hey. It's a transitional move now, like the one-winged angel.
Yeah. Top rope elbow.
Yeah, an elbow drop.
Top rope elbow.
That's not a transitional move. That's clearly a finisher. Two.
Gee. Oh,
no.
But he kicked out.
Oh, is he going for another?
Another one?
That would be insane. It's like when Kylo goes for a double Starkiller. Ah, nah. Just
nope,
a double knee.
Stomp.
You know, a double knee, it should be like probably like more damaging than an elbow drop, but hey.
You'd think.
Yeah.
Well, maybe his elbow's made of metal and his knees aren't.
Oh yeah, and this is a lot of back and forth, actually. I know I said it at the start of the match, but I didn't expect it to actually happen.
Yeah.
I think Annual just might have the best matches with people. Maybe you should book him more often.
Yeah. Perhaps the Buskus or the Bunny Champ next week.
Another freaking pile driver, is this it? Transitional move. Yes, the move that temporarily paralyzed Stone Cold Steve Austin for real is a transitional move. Good stuff. Aw man, he baned Anil.
Sure did. And
the elbow could be the double fist drop. Oh yeah, he's doing it.
Nope.
It's also finished somehow. I didn't know Macho Man did that. Or Macro Man, I mean. Two. No.
Oh, but
that was so
again.
Damn close, though.
Macro Man's getting frustrated. Oh.
I'm not even sure that hit, but, you know.
It sort of hit. I was just punching him.
He's reversing it.
Reversed.
Oh, he's going for something big, I think. I hope. I want to see something big, something bloody. Oh, yeah, he's doing something. Oh, holy shit. Oh, yeah.
Macroman's crawling away.
Well, it doesn't really impress Anil from the looks of it.
Nope. Giving him some punching. Ooh!
Ooh! DTT into
the turnbuckle.
Into the turnbuckle, yeah. Oh, the move!
Ooh. The whatever that was, the spin move.
The move, yeah.
One, two.
Oh my
god.
Oh,
what a kick out.
And he can't believe
Anil
it.
Anil can't believe it. Yeah.
Oh, but oh, he might be
going for
the Exploder now. Oh yeah, that's the Exploder.
Yep. Into the corner, sort of.
One, two, three.
Three.
You
got it.
Oh yeah.
I should have known. I bet on Macro Man.
Oh yeah, we can predict results by. Well, whoever will win is the guy you don't bet on. That's how it usually goes.
Shit.
Except
well,
sometimes.
Usually.
We need to figure out the algorithm or something. I don't know.
Yes. I went like 4-6 during the tournament last week, so.
That's not so bad, actually.
Yeah. I'm wrong more than I'm right, but I'm not always wrong.
Mm. You're inconsistently wrong.
Yes.
So next up, we will have the Bunny Championship match. A Kylo Ren who reinvented himself
Oh, well, we see the return of the hot bod.
Well, not the hot bod. That's only, like, reserved for special occasions.
Oh.
But he's wearing his Edgelord attire.
Oh? So he has new gear?
I mean, it's the same he wore last week, like, only with a shirt on and his mask.
Oh.
Oh, at first... Oh, yeah, right. We have to visit Rara. Like, I could swear she escaped somehow last week, but apparently that didn't happen.
Oh. Oh, so... You've just jumped another timeline, then.
What do you mean, timeline? I don't understand timelines. I mean, clearly, there's only... Yeah, there's... We messed up big. We messed up very, very big. I mean, I mostly did, but...
Yeah. I was like, I didn't do anything.
Oh man, the crate just pinned Rara. Title change!
Again?
Oh yeah. Well, Ref Cho, explain the logistics of the crate pinning Rara.
Damn it, Iggy. You're drunk. Don't question the rules.
I'm not drunk. I mean...
Damn it, Iggy. You're not drunk.
Yeah. Like, I'm not sure which is worse. Oh man, Rara just only got a 2 count when trying to pin the crate. This is hard, you know?
Yeah. The timeline where Rara's getting pinned a million times.
It was a 57th title change, I believe Cho said. Like, since last week alone. Well, really, there's up or down relative to something.
So if Rara's getting pinned a million times in that timeline, what's Rara doing in this timeline, where she broke free?
Do you know the power of the dark side?
Oh, I do.
It was the first aura, which so far only has 2 members.
Yeah.
Of course, it's basically the Aura 66, only without Palpy.
Yeah. Oh, they'll just have to add more members.
You know, maybe eventually, if someone edgy enough shows up.
Nice.
Maybe D is edgy enough.
Yeah,
maybe this is
say, maybe D.
Maybe this is recruitment.
Just one way or the other, they'll have the bunny champ.
You know, I find it kind of funny that the bunny belt is usually held by people who look really like menacing.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the caves are pretty good, but they also know you like edgy stuff.
Yeah, the belts only ever had thematically appropriate holders like a couple of times. With Getterrier, Retro, and Rudy. Or not Rudy, Fomander.
Yeah, Fruity never held it.
Yeah.
He had to escape the Buskus first. Here comes a good boy, look at that. Carrying the belt with pride.
They'll destroy anyone who wants to take that bunny champ from him.
But can he destroy someone who knows the power of the dark side?
Maybe. I mean, he did destroy Palpatine to get the belt, didn't he? Wait, no, that wasn't Palpatine.
No, that Flamander. Was Flamander, yeah.
I'm getting my reins mixed up.
Yeah, Flamander was the one who beat Palpatine after, like, a record reign of, like, 6 defenses.
Well, by MMA rules, he beat Flamander who beat Palpatine, so I guess he does know how to destroy the power of the dark side.
Totally, yeah.
Oh, shit. Got the bet.
Well, see ya, Hal.
Bye, Hal.
You have like 18 seconds left. 15.
Oops.
Oh, it's perfect. One of you bet on Kyle, the other on D. So don't have to actually weigh in.
Oh. That's good.
It's great to have a 50-50 split. That means nobody knows who's going to win.
Well, I mean, bet on Kylo, so I think that's a good indicator for who's winning this.
True. Also, it's a rather small sample size, so this actually indicates anything. Two people. So many. He's just making Kylo run. Oops, uppercut. Yeah, one punch! Yeah. And who would have managed this was KO and he just won?
Yeah.
Punching out a oh my god, fuck the choke slam! Ah.
If he had won that one punch, you would have had to give him the One Punch Man theme song.
Yeah, like, Fred Hoeveland would have given it up and he would have gotten it. Because he deserves it.
Ooh. One of those moves that you can't tell who's supposed to be hurt until after it's done.
I mean, it's a Sunset Flip power bomb, so I know who's gonna be the one who gets hurt, but only because I know what the move is.
Kylo doing some lucha in this match.
Oh, wait, that's just Kylo.
That famous luchador Kylo Ren.
I mean, he's wearing a mask.
That's true.
I mean, so is D.
So is D.
Who's old and luchador? Face. Because luchador means wrestler. Or fighter, rather, I think. I'm not sure. I don't know Spanish.
Well, let's look it up.
Just choking Kylo on the ground.
Yeah, it's basically just a Mexican term for a wrestler.
Yeah.
Oh. Left the ring and then came back in.
Yep, that was good. That was a very, interesting moment of the match. I'm sure it was pivotal to the outcome. Ooh. Good old Rana here.
Ooh. Top rope.
He's bringing the flips.
Yeah. Oh,
will they go outside? No, just taunting now. Yeah,
just paying for it.
I love when that happens. It's so good. Oh yeah. One, two. Of course, D won't stay down for that. Come on. Oh, but this could be the move. Oh yes, Starkiller.
Yes.
One, two. No, not enough.
Does anyone in the LPFWA have a Starship Pain as a finisher?
Not as a finisher, but I think as a regular move.
That's John Morrison's move, everyone, if you don't know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's like some kind of corkscrew twisty thing in the corner. It's a move.
Yeah, but it's cool, so.
It's also called the end of the world in Lucha Underground.
Yeah.
Where it's called Johnny Mundo. Or in TNA where it's called Johnny fucking Impact. Oh, and Kylo just reversed the Canadian Space Program Mark 1. Yeah.
Or John Hennigan, which is his real name when he's wrestling everywhere else.
Johnny Impact.
Yeah.
Like, it's if I called myself Iggy LPFWA.
I mean, it's a hell of a gimmick. Just change your last name wherever you go. You don't have to worry about trademarking.
Yeah. Or just go by Johnny. Just Johnny.
Like Cody Rhodes.
Yeah. I mean, it works for Cody.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the one,
two, three? Three. Oh, shit, I won.
Well, that's...
Nelson Kylo.
That's interesting.
Yes. Well, we have a new bunny jump. Congratulations.
Yep. A new dark age for the bunny championship belt thing.
Yes. The bunny jump will know the dark side once again.
Because believe it or not, D is a face.
I don't believe it.
He's a very kind soul.
Huh. You don't expect that from the Destroyer.
He's just got some ketchup on his mask.
Mmm.
Well. Let's see for how long he can hold onto that belt. Can he top Palpy's reign?
Let's see him with that belt first.
Oh, he has to surpass Palpy's reign now, doesn't he?
Yeah.
To prove that he is worthy.
Yes. Yeah, once again, get another thematic champion with this belt. Look at him.
If he actually makes it that far, he will have to make the defense that would surpass Palpy's against
Palpy. As long as he twerks on the belt every week, he will embrace the power.
I think I can arrange that.
Of the bunny champ, the dark. Oh.
Oh, it's that match.
It's time for my boys. Oh no. I'm torn between betting on my boys and not betting on them so they're not jinxed. Tell me, Iggy, what do I do?
Roll dice. That's what I always do.
Fuck.
Well, good luck, I guess.
Fuck. No. Shit, I hate this.
What are you gonna do? It's lose-lose for you, really.
Yeah. God, Tommy's Wiseau can't win.
I mean, but Angus could, right?
I'm fine with Angus winning.
Man, I'm looking forward
on
to
him. He would make a fine addition to the Sinners.
I'm looking forward to Tommy actually getting a pinfall after an elbow drop to the ass off Goatman.
Yeah.
It's gonna happen. It's the most over move in sports entertainment. No one's ever kicked out of it.
Fine.
Oh. Well, playing it risky, I see. Maybe the best move would have been to not play.
Maybe. No bone pimp this time. He's following the rules.
Yeah, unfortunately he couldn't get a Johnny Gat mask in time.
Yeah.
And these pants look good in those guys. Like,
yeah.
I mean, actually the color just really doesn't mesh well with the purple, but whatever.
Yeah.
Here we go. This could be the match to end all matches. Until the next match, which we'll be right after. Strategizing before the match, I see. They have a plan. You just know it.
Yeah. That plan is saying this is going to drink beer.
To drink all our beer, which is Which way? Don't have any beer. Or anything else.
Well, that's why you don't have beer. It's because Angus took it all.
Yeah, what a jerk. If he was Dash, I'd feud against him now, but... Eh, it's Angus.
Yeah.
He's allowed to do that.
Oh god. I just realized... Is Tommy was so the face in this match?
Because...
Sinners are the heels.
You know, LPFWA is not a very traditional wrestling corporation. It's more or less just like pretty much every match is either face versus face or heel versus heel. Usually.
Man started us off, but then got his ass kicked.
The ref is the face. He'll take a bump, probably.
Yeah.
So to build sympathy for him. Oh, yes. Going outside.
The goat men are facing off.
Yeah, man, Angus should have worn the goat outfit. Well, we could now make the remark about championship advantage or something like that. But this isn't WWE.
Yeah.
Oh, punched him right in the face, which is where he does most of his damage, by headbutting people.
Yes.
Oh, hot tag!
Hot tag! And a lightish tag.
Oh, he's hitting.
Ooh, it is the hot tag this time.
It is! Not lukewarm.
Not like at Tox Party.
Oh god, it's hot.
Yes, not like at Tox Party, where...
Well, we had a hot tag at Tox Party.
Immediately got his ass kicked.
Well, Freddy had the hot tag afterwards.
Yes. Well, then Goatman tagged in and he got his ass kicked too.
That's just how it goes.
Have a perfect night for them.
They won!
You know, they won. Anna said, it was a good night, it wasn't a perfect night.
It was a night.
Yes. They ceased being losers.
Ooh. Whoa. Oh yeah, just slamming the face into the mat. No hot tag. Tommy was trying.
Ooh. Is he going to tag in? Yes.
Oh yeah. Suplex in the cat.
Ooh. Punch to the face.
Showing him the power of the dark side!
Showing us his upskirt shot.
Yep, nice. That's just yeah, actually, this is one of those wrestling federations, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, if anyone wanted to know if Angus was a eunuch. I don't know. Going for a top rope something.
Ooh.
Knees.
The knees are now officially called the top rope something.
Ooh, into the corner.
I thought they were going for a tag move for sure.
Oh, just kicking his ass. Stomping, got nothing. Ooh, reversal. Whatever that was.
Oh, that was a punch, I think. And holy shit, that music is loud compared to the other music. Wow.
Yeah. Scratch post.
One, two.
Oh, what did you get?
He's going.
What the hell are you doing, Goat Man?
It's a top rope move. Is it a top rope something, though?
Top rope requires someone to get up and move, though. Ooh, top rope elbow, which he missed.
Yep.
Oh. Back on the outside.
Not just kicking around the goat man. Yes.
Not actually kicking him, just kicking around him. What's funny about this is they both have the headbutt as a move, but
they have different headbutts. Goatman,
yeah, for Goatman, it's his signature.
Yeah, it's also just straight up different headbutts. Oh, this could be the headbutt though, the True Brew. Yep.
Yeah.
And this could be it.
No.
One, two.
Oh, he kicked out. You'd think a headbutt from a guy with horns would hurt more, but...
You'd think.
What do you know? Tommy doing something.
Oh, he's doing something! He's... Oh, yeah. This could be big.
Middle rope something. Middle rope. Fists.
That should hurt Tommy.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, you're grabbing him, the horn stabbing you in the arms.
Tommy just interrupted the headbutt, I think.
Oh. Headbutt to the throat.
There it goes.
Oh, there's the headbutt.
Oh, it's the shitty, like, arm drag or whatever.
Yeah.
His signature move. One. And two.
Two. Oh, buddy
no.
kick. Shitty arm drag ain't worth shit.
Well, maybe he'll do the I'll kill you bastard next time.
Which is?
A shitty snap suplex.
Alright.
Like, the shittiest one I could find. Oh yeah, this could be the shitty, like, I kill you bastard move. Yep. That needed to be in the corner.
Oh, hello.
What the hell?
There's some dissension in the unlikely
Is mates. There? I don't know. What's happening?
I mean...
Maybe he wants him to finish it, yeah! Because Tommy's an idiot. He should have gone for the pin right away, really.
Yeah.
After doing his shitty move.
I mean, Angus has made it no secret he wants to join the Hug Rule Warriors.
But he's not huggy enough, or is he?
Okay. Sure, those. Stomp the air, buddy. You do you.
It was almost a headbutt. Oh, he's thinking about something.
Doing something. Thinking about punching him. And doing that.
Oh.
Whatever that was.
It's a series of moves. Super kick.
Ooh, super kick.
Just
stomp to the face.
Kicking him. Ah.
He's just being a dick now.
So rude. He's just kicking him around. MGM out of nowhere, clearly telegraphed. And blood.
Oh, and blood.
One, two. Broken up.
Tommy broke it up.
Oh my god, is angry at Tommy. Oh my god.
Tommy staggered from those punches.
Well, Angus looks to be doing fine, even though he just got his ass whooped back and down the ring.
Yes, and he's bleeding.
I mean, to be fair, like, his blood is basically whiskey.
That's true.
Oh, they're gonna do a move. Nope, they're not.
No, it's just elbows in the corner.
I thought they were gonna do some sick stuff, but he will, whatever.
Oh, knee to the head. Yeah, I probably hurt him too, since, you know, caught the horns in it, but, you know.
Yeah, it's wrestling.
What you gonna do? Knee him in the horns and pretend it like it doesn't hurt.
Just going for the one, pin immediately. Two. What the fuck?
Oh. I think it's doing something
but
Chris.
But Chris Pine is now out of commission for the time being.
Yeah.
So Goat is on his own.
Oh.
Well, he's doing fine on his own.
Yeah.
I told you he's taking a bump. Oh, headbutt. Ooh, again.
Another headbutt. Oh, he's doing another one? No. Throwing him in the corner.
I bet he knows that Chris isn't there. So he's saving his big move. I don't think the AI is that smart.
It would certainly be a surprise if it was. Oh, Chris appears to be having trouble getting back onto the
shitty paper. Arm drag. Oh my god. What an impactful move. One.
Two.
Oh,
and save.
Could have been it.
Yeah. Tommy attempting to grab Chris, but Chris is long gone.
well. Maybe a different timeline he was still there.
Maybe.
Oh, but now the shitty suplex. I mean, I kill you, you bastard. That's the move, yeah.
But we'll... No, he's going for a pin again.
He should just pin. No. But this time, Angus, yeah, okay, fine. I'm going to do it. I'm going to... Yeah.
Angus not going for a pin.
Tom needs to learn when to... Oh. Another MTM out of nowhere, clearly telegraphed. Yes.
Oh.
That's the second one he took.
One.
Run. Just run. Thanks, Tommy. What's Chris doing? I don't know.
Whatever it was, it wasn't successful.
Well, whatever.
Now, Angus is going for a top rope something.
Oh, that was indeed a top rope something.
But he missed.
Clearly missed.
Ooh.
Oh, that's his signature. Like a shitty clothesline. But do we have any episode titles yet, by the way? I might have missed them.
I didn't see any.
Three. Oh, fuck. Gold keeps losing to shitty moves. I mean, it's his signature, to be fair, but still. It's kind of impressive. Whoop. The unlikely roommates are the new unlikely champions. Maybe we should rename the belts. Ah, well.
There's your episode title.
I will save that to my text file of episode titles. Oh man, he's bleeding, I forgot.
Yeah.
That is some blood. Well, Thundercat, Chris Pine will have another match in just a second.
Yeah.
But that one's not canon, you know. Except if it is. But it probably isn't.
No, it's a match with prospective center Fruity. God damn it, Goat Man.
I mean,
well, at least he wasn't pinned by Tommy Wiseau. I would have had to disown him again.
Yeah, that would have been harsh. Oh, well, look at that. That's a good match. A cat and a crazy person versus a cat and a crazy person.
On the plus side, Chris Pine stayed on the outside of the ring for most of the last match, so he should be mostly fresh.
Well, he did stuff.
Well, yeah, he did stuff, but it was mostly Goatman in the ring.
And Fruity is wearing his house show tights. Because of course he is. Still rocking a hug life tattoo. I mean, maybe, just maybe, yeah. He hugged somebody. Like,
yeah, he hugged them.
And last time he wrestled against New Japan guys, he actually like hugged three of them and made them tap.
Yeah. I mean, you could always exchange hug life for hug money.
Oh look, there's the Raw thing somehow in the New Japan arena.
The joint show.
Ah yeah, sure. It's a joint show between LPFWA, New Japan, and somehow WWE. I mean, the Raw arena does belong to us, so...
It's Chris Pine coming out alone.
And now, Hiromu Takahashi and Daryl come out together because they are a unit. My favorite Hiromu Takahashi feud is against Will Ospreay. Because Hiromu was trying to convince Ospreay that he's a cat. Or rather, he was insisting he's a cat. And Ospreay just denied it. Fruity getting in the first move.
Stomp to the near the face.
Well, I'm getting the first moves, but Hiromu gets in the big moves.
Yeah. Ooh. Over the top rope flippy thing.
Ah, yes. The favorite DDT of all those guys. Oh my god, oh, Daryl is in.
Yes, see how he does. I thought for a second I was going to tag back out.
That would have been hilarious. Oh, the Daryl dropkick! The Daryl being, like, face planted. That was unfortunate.
Stomp to the ass.
Almost as devastating as an elbow drop to the ass.
Almost. Oh,
the weird back hug.
Yes. I mean, he is hugging.
Technically.
It's fine going for a middle rope. Splash.
It's just splashing onto the cat. Cat on cat action. Ooh, another Daryl dropkick.
I haven't been watching as much New Japan as I should, so I don't know a whole lot about Daryl.
Well, Daryl is Hiromu's plush cat. Like, it's literally just a plushie.
Ooh, surfboard. Will he get the pin? or tap submission.
Yeah, get the pin off of that. I mean, it could happen technically in some promotions.
Well, his shoulders were down. Chris Pines.
Yeah, that's not how it works in New Japan, though. Like, you actually need to go for a pinfall.
Ooh, team move. I mean, clearly being around the center has brought out Fruity's hug.
Just kissing Fruity!
Oh
my god, what the- oh.
Punch on the other side of the
oh
ropes.
Oh my god, he's punching him! He's not stopping! Yeah.
What's happening?
Fruity's getting punched. Daryl's not stopping. Oh my god, he's dazed!
I was gonna say, did the- you break the timeline again, Iggy?
No. Not as far as I know. Oh, I already broke it. I can't break it more, I think.
You sure about that?
I'm not going to try to find out. Well, Fruity seems to be glad that he's not dead. But hey,
or
killed by a cat is actually one of the better deaths. Always going for the hot tag.
So Daryl's going for another tag. Oh, here we go. Oh, is it a hot tag?
Oh,
it is.
It is so lukewarm. Very warm. Hot. Okay, it's a hot tag. Like that's actually a 2-for-2 for Thundercat Chris Pine's hot tags.
Yes, he's having a good night. He's learned from the last time. Ooh, they're reversed.
I'll just make a gif of Daryl punching Fruity forever, though.
Yes.
What's he doing? Okay. I understand that. I understand everything. Okay, that's a move.
It sure was. Ooh, Chris has reversed.
Oh, so this is the second tag match in a row. This is almost like it's really New Japan. Oh, yeah. The scratching post.
Ooh. He's going for the pin.
One.
Two.
What the fuck was this?
I don't know.
Hiromu knocked over the ref, yeah. And then Fruity just fell onto him.
I mean, he technically made the save.
He needed something, and the ref took the fall for it.
Oh. Ooh, punches to the ass. Back.
Oh, Canadian Destroyer! Oh man, that's good. Just posing! I mean, after Canadian Destroyer, okay, just pose, it's okay. It's a good move. Could've also pinned him, but hey, it's okay.
Why go for a pin when you can pose?
Yeah.
Do that. Now he's
going. One, two.
Oh, no. Kick out.
Not enough. To put down the former COCOM champion, Thundercat, yes. Chris Pine.
Going for a pin? Yeah, oh. Or not pin.
It is Fruity now, ready to hug the cat.
One can only hope.
Meow.
Nope, he's doing that instead.
It works. Is he going for the pin now, or what's he doing? He's going. Oh, okay, good. I was very confused there for a moment.
Clearly, being around the sinners has brought out his hug. Oh, more punching.
Oh. Ah, that was a
sort
move.
Of.
It's a signature, actually.
A hugplex.
It's a Bailey to back. Actually, it's not a. Yeah. Whatever. Ah, Electro.
Ooh.
One.
Ah.
Can't put down a cat like that. It doesn't work. Gotta pet it first. Give it a belly rub. Oh. Daryl wanted to go for the hot tag.
Oh, more hugging.
Fruity's in control.
Will he go for the big hug? Yes! No! Fuck. Well, he went for it.
Yep. That might have been it. Oh, Daryl doing the special walk.
Ooh, top rope. Drop.
Did the Daryl drop kick in honor of Daryl, who just tagged out.
Oh! Another drop kick, but he failed. I was chopping. Oh, going for another. Oh.
For a thing.
Going for another surfboard, but he did that instead.
It was technically a surfboard in some way. Just not suspended in midair.
Yeah.
Just another sidestepping those drop kicks, yeah. Oh, could be 619. Oh, I think. Not quite,
nope,
no.
Nope, just ass to the back of the head.
He does have a 619, though. Oh, hot tag. Oh, Daryl is in. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Is a hot tag. Nope.
Nope, still
nope,
hot.
To that, too.
It's still hot.
Still, whatever that was.
Oh, no. Another Canadian destroyer.
Rudy's dead.
Oh, yeah, Daryl just pin dead. Him, Daryl. Just pin. Oh, Daryl.
Got to stomp on his dick first.
Yep, stomp the dick. Because a Canadian destroyer is not powerful enough, apparently. Oh, triangle.
That was another match where Chris Pine spent most of the time on the outside.
I mean, that's just a Chris Pine story. He's better for short bursts, apparently. He did his finisher once.
Yeah. Oh, immediately going for the pin.
One, two.
Two.
Oh, but he does kick out.
And Chris Pine has been killed.
Yeah. Didn't do anything, just dies.
Ooh.
Oh, he's doing something. He's revving up a hug, I think.
Do it. Nope, stomp. Ooh, spear into the corner. What is he doing? Elbow into the corner.
He's doing a thing. Oh, his sick, the weirdo back hug. And one,
two, three? Three. Got it.
Yeah, that's it. And just for good measure!
Just for good measure, one cat killed another cat.
I mean, the kind of way before anything happened. Just. It's funnier that way, actually.
Yeah.
It seems like every time Fruity is, like, wrestling New Japan guys, he just unleashes his inner demon.
Yeah. Well, at least the saint, the sinner's got one win tonight.
You actually won that bet, yeah.
Yeah, I bet on my boy again. Yeah, Rudy, Third Street Sinners, think about it.
And he's in the Hagaru Warriors, though. They're named after him. Partially.
Well. They could always still call themselves the Hagaru Warriors even after he leaves.
Well, it's time for our main event. DCB, who had a shocking win against Talvi last week by countout. Which won't help her today for two reasons. First of all, it's a title match, and you can't really win a title by countout. Plus, Talvi somehow requested there be no countout.
Is it false count anywhere?
No, just no countout.
Oh.
I believe in DCB.
I don't.
I'm sending her my energy right now. Talvi could have been the first women's champion if it weren't for the dumb countout loss, actually, yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe she's upset. Maybe she isn't. Maybe. It's hard to tell because she's wearing a mask.
Maybe she'll kill DCB for what happened last week.
Has anyone ever seen her actual face?
Does she have a face?
I mean, her mask has a mouth and eyes, so technically that's a face? DCB is trying to continue her mission of beating everybody via pinfall. So far, she's beaten exactly one person, Helena. Which is impressive, but... you know... every other win has been by countout. All three other wins.
Well, maybe that's just gonna be her gimmick from now on. She wins by countout.
Yeah.
Except for this match.
If she wins this by countout somehow, I call shenanigans. Because it's not possible. There's no countout.
There we go. Oh, DCB starting us off.
Starting off? Yeah, she usually starts really strong.
Then multiple missed stomps.
Whiffs stomps to the mask. What's that move? What the fuck? This convoluted fucking setup for just a... like, neck
a thing.
Breaker thing, whatever that was.
Yeah, it was a neck breaker. Elbow. To the throat.
It's the weirdest setup for a move I've ever seen. And people say the setup for the One Winged Angel is convoluted, but that's a transitional move, so it's fine.
Another neck breaker. Going for middle rope.
Whoopsie.
Oh, but she missed. Probably with some missed stomps of her own. Oh.
Ooh. Oh, wow. Slapping her. That's kind of rude.
Perhaps DCB's turning heel. Oh.
I mean, DCB has had the Young Bucks moveset since forever, and they technically are heels, depending on who you ask. I mean, in Japan, they're heels. Mostly. Because they're Bullet Club. Ooh, deadlifting something. I think it was a gut-wrench suplex or whatever. Probably.
Another one? No.
Like that move, just throwing her around.
Oh, no. Fists to the side of the head.
Yeah. Just stomping.
Yep.
Oh.
Oh. To the face.
Oh, wow. Lifting her up, like, wow. I think Talvi is the heaviest, except maybe for Samus.
I think so.
Maybe Yelitsa Veta's. I'm not sure. I set their weight up at some point. I'm not sure how heavy they are, or how heavy I can even make them. Scott Steiner elbow drop.
Up in.
One count. Oh. Normally, if you go one on one another wrestler, you get a 50-50 chance of winning. But Tolga's a genetic freak, and she's not normal. So GCB, like, she's already dead.
Yeah.
Oh my god, dropkick. Maybe she's not dead yet. More dropkicks.
Ooh. Stop. Another gut wrench suplex.
Yep. Just straight up deadlifting her.
DCB may be running out of caffeine at this point.
You'd think at this point she would have devised a new brew that would, like, just have its effect work for a little longer. Maybe she should switch to Blackout God.
Clearly she needs to level up her coffee making skills.
I mean, I think they're already at, like, level 999.
Well, needs to go to level 1000.
Oh, this is it's her finisher, the Muscle Buster.
Can she get the pin?
One, two, three. Welp. Looks like DZB is not gonna get a pinfall victory tonight. Maybe some other time.
Well, I won. So I'm happy.
That's weird. Must be an alternate timeline.
I mean, I was betting against DCB, so, like, that's a one sure bet.
True. But she's won matches. Now, so... You'd think the curse might be broken. If there ever was such a thing. She has higher stats than most people, though, so I don't know why she's losing. Oh, spooky, scary, and still a kawaii champion. She sure likes to celebrate for a long time.
Yes, she does.
What?
Something happening now?
Well, this has been the last match. So what's gonna happen now? Except for spooky scary skeletons playing until the end. Because the show is spooky and scary. And, well, to think of it, the show started with Bone Pimp. Who is technically a skeleton, or makes bone guns? Like, he has a skeleton, is the thing.
Yes, he has a skeleton inside him.
Yep.
And outside him.
Yeah. And Talvi as well. She has a skeleton.
Yes. In fact, everyone has skeletons inside them.
Maybe. That is actually true. My mind is blown. But yeah, anyway, this has been the show. I hope you liked it. I liked it. It's over now, though.
Yes. Until next week.
Of course you liked it. I pay you to say that.
Yeah.
Well, anyway. It's been fun. So see ya next time when we do some more streaming with wrestling and stuff. Goodbye.